Hey guys, it's Brandon, and welcome to another installment to the home recording series, Recreation, because recording at home should be fun. This is a highly requested episode where I show how I do MIDI drums. In the description, you can download my preset for all this. It should translate everything if you happen to have Superior Drummer 2.0 and the Avatar kit. Most of this is actually somebody else's preset, but I tweaked it a little bit. When you're gonna be plotting drums, enable the snapping. This little magnet here is gonna enable you to move things around, and it snaps to your grid, which your grid you can set up here. So I would add a new track. I just hit Control T. That's how I added that. And then I go to Effects. And then for me, Superior Drummer, so I hit OK. And then it adds it to the mix, basically. Now, I do also want to point out that these are being routed. I'll leave this here up on the screen so you can see exactly how I've got this set up. I've got these routed to separate tracks, and I'll show you. This is as a parent track. These little tracks here are the child tracks. Basically like this, so you can see the kick and the toms are receiving from 1-2 channel, and I'll show you where you actually do that. You have to first set it up in Superior Drummer 2.0, and if you download my preset, this should translate over to also. It's in the mixer part over here, so you can see this is a kick, and so you can see the out is 1 and 2. Every single snare is set to a 3-4 out. You can click that. You can change the out. In the end, I want to be able to control the kick and the toms together as one single unit and just do any final tweaks on it. The snare needs to be separate also. The overhead's the same. So all the overheads is set out to 5 and 6. So that is why when you go to the I/O, this first little box represents, you know, what's coming from the Superior Drummer. So I set up under Stereo Source 3 and 4, so it's matching exactly what's in Superior Drummer. However you set it up here, set up exactly the same way in Reaper. And so for the kick and the toms, I just basically put, you know, a high pass for snare. I've got an EQ here and then a limiter to make sure it doesn't clip. And then a snare reverb. I'll go ahead and click through these because I want to set this as a separate tutorial on actually how I mix these drums. So I'm going to click through this really quickly just so at least you see what I'm doing. In the mix drum kit, I've got this set up to give that really tight tape distortion sound that really punches through on the mix. And then EQ, and then a little bit of reverb to glue the whole drum kit together. Okay, so that is a summary. We can go into that more in depth in a later episode. I do want to focus on the purpose of this tutorial is mainly to focus on how you actually program these drums once they're set up. Go under your Superior Drummer and go to the grooves section. I've got a lot to choose from here. So what I'm gonna do is I can just go through all of these, you know, I'll just sometimes spend several minutes looking through each of these grooves, listening to see what fits. Okay, that sounds cool. I have to drag the last little selection into. I can't drag it from this groove here. It won't work. I have to hold, click, and drag this part, you know, into the groove and just pull it in. So about like that. All right, and then I can play it. And, you know, I'll show you a quick way in Reaper. You don't have to keep dragging the same groove over and over. If you want to use that same exact groove with no fill-ins and stuff, you can actually just drag this, you know, infinitely. And that's usually what I do. If I have a cool groove that I like and I don't want to keep programming, I want to keep the juices flowing for recording just to get the idea out. But what I usually like to do is just kind of mix up the grooves a little bit. So let's just say this is the groove that I like. So let's just listen here. All right, so I may want to pick a groove that's similar to that. Okay, that sounds kind of cool. Let's add that next. What I may want to do is to make it a little bit more interesting at the end here to add a little fill. Actually not that bad. No, so we can actually use that one. Let's just use that for an example. Now what I do, if I have a solo track that's up or a track up here that is free, I put it up here so I can measure exactly how much I need to cut it off. If I want to use that entire fill, I'll position it up here, and I'm like, okay, well, I know I need to pull this back that much, and then pull it like that, and that's how I do it. So let's just say that, you know, I'm listening to that fill. I'm like, that fill kind of breaks it up a little bit. I think I'm just going to cut that in half. The easiest way I do is I'll zoom out to a point where I've only got, like, I see that this is cut up into four pieces. Position your cursor right there in the middle and just pull it right over. And then now, voila, you got. And that does sound, that does flow a little bit better. Now I can do, if I want to copy all of this, I usually won't copy the same fill if it's going to be for the actual song, because then it sounds too much like before. Instead of using my normal clicker, I'll use the right click, and then that enables you in Reaper to select just a small portion. Hold down the control and shift, then drag over, and then it makes a copy of them. And then you'll notice that, you know, you'll want to snap it to the grid again. Slide it over, and now you've got a copy and pasted portion. Now, I need to add another fill in here. Yeah, let's use that one. Okay. You don't want every single drum hit to be the same velocity. So I don't, if I'm gonna, you know, plot some toms, I don't want every single one to be that same velocity. See that? I want them to be varied. Otherwise, it's gonna sound like a robot. By the way, you can also right-click this and hit glue items, because if you don't, in this way, if I were to add a note, it adds that everywhere. But if you glue them together, it makes it more like an actual canvas that's not copy and pasted. You can just add the notes wherever you want. So my point here is, if I want to humanize this entire groove, I can hit Control A, and then I can hit the H. So humanize notes, you can select either only selected notes that you want, or you can do all notes, and you can vary this how you want. You can do new random seed, and you can see how these are changing as I go. See how those are just giving you random. I'll normally just click through this real fast and then just like, okay, there we go. There's my random seed. And so you can vary the timing if you want to. You don't want to do it too much, because then it makes it sound like your programmed drummer is not very good. And on the timing biased, if you have it over to the negative, it appears that what it does is it shifts to where your drummer is anticipating the notes more, so they're ahead of the beat a little bit more, and if you put them all the way over to extreme 100%, then what it does is your drummer is a little bit behind, just close to zero, you know. The drums are a little bit more varied. They sound a little bit better. Just a little bit of a change, you know? So that way, not every single snare hit is at full 100 max. So now for your own grooves, I'll have this starting point. I'm gonna make sure that I've got my superior drummer selected. You don't want another track selected, because if I go up to insert new MIDI item, it'll add it on that track, and then I gotta move it back up here. You know, I'll normally drag this out a couple of times. Let's see, like that, for example. And then I'll, you know, glue those together, so that way I've got a bigger canvas to write on for drums, if you will. Now, by default, you may have been wondering how I get that diamond look for the drums. That's actually the drum mapper mode. Yeah, you'll go up to the view and piano roll notes. Your default is going to be rectangles, and you'll want to change that to diamonds or triangles, whichever one you want. It's just the aesthetics. You can do it however you want. For years, I used the rectangles, and rectangles is usually what you'll use for, you know, programming actual notes. You know, it doesn't matter how long you make that rectangle. It's still a kick. You can't stretch out that sound. So that's why they make it to where in drum mode, it is just a single point on the MIDI map. What I normally do is start out with the kick drum. I got the guitars muted just so you can hear these drums a little bit easier. Let's just say I want to do the double kick, a double kick sound. I can change the grid, the way it looks here, the way it plots. So let's just say we'll just keep with the eighth notes. I'll just click. I'm gonna hit Control C for copy, and then paste. Now we've got, cool deal, all right. So now where do we want the snare? Okay, let's do it right there. Okay, cool. That's nice. Let me expand this out. All right, at this point, I'm gonna go ahead and hit glue. Now I've got that bigger canvas that I talked about. Reason I did this is because I like the where the snare is placed, but I wanna add something a little bit. I hear it in my head, and that's how I'll plot them. Let's see here. No, that's not it, let's see. Yeah. Yeah, okay, that's how I'm gonna do it, okay. Basically, you just listen to whatever. You can hear the drums in your head. If you listen to music enough, you can just hear it in your head. And then you just try to find where it is on the piano roll. There we go. And there's the main groove. So now all I gotta do is add cymbals. Now, something really important to know when you're programming drums, remember that your drummer is not an octopus, so don't have him play like five cymbals, a snare, and a kick all at the same time. So do air drumming just to see if that's actually possible. Besides the snare, the cymbals can really help gauge how you want the song to feel. Do you want the song to feel halftime, or do you want it to be like really fast? And I'll show you what I mean. I like that. Oh, and here's another thing also. What I like to do is when I'm in the beginning of a phrase, I like to have a crash, and then so it's a different sound than the rest of the beat, just to make it, you know, it's like makes your chorus just hit real hard. So let's go with this one for right now. Okay, so there's the beginning of the phrase. All right, so let's see, we'll do this. Kind of boring, right? I'm gonna add even more hits. Now, it's gonna be really good. Now let me vary some notes real quick. All right. Now it's got more energy. See, and you know, if you decide, it's like, you know what? I don't like those cymbals after all. Let's move these, let me find another one. I just found a better beginning hit right here. I want to move these down here. Yeah, that sounds better. See what I mean? You know, because the beginning, I want that to be a really loud crash. Now, if I want to humanize these a little bit more, I can, you know, have these selected, hit the H button. Maybe I don't want to vary all the notes. Maybe I just want to select just these ones for right now. Each one has its own unique velocity. I'm just gonna do this individually. I want these to be really close to the top, but okay, about right there. Now we've got much more human sounding drums. I'm not really, really good at fills, so I'll usually steal fills from the grooves. I could glue this little groove piece together. And so now it's one unit, so I can go into here, and maybe I love everything about it, I just want to change what the cymbal hits sound like. I can just select every single one of them to here somewhere. Sounds like that. In the last chorus over here, I actually had this more of a, you know, a triplet fill. And I'll show you how I did that. So in here, under this little thing, you can go, you know, from straight to triplet, dotted, or swing. It changes your grid. This is the triplet fill. And then the snare. In a nutshell, that should be all that you need to know as far as getting started on programming MIDI drums. I know this was a long video, but there's a lot that goes into it. So I hope you enjoyed today's video. And again, if you have any questions at all, please don't hesitate to leave those in the comments below. I'll try to do at least one recording tutorial every month. And if you would love to support my career on YouTube, you can go to my patreon.com/BrandonBurch. Your support in return, you get some neat perks, videos early. I share my Photoshop projects with you there and many more. I hope all of you have a great weekend, and I will see you next time.